Hello, I'm Dr. Joe Caudill, the State Deer Research Biologist for Indiana, and today I am coming to you once again from the first floor of the Bloomington Field Office in beautiful Monroe County, Indiana. I head up a team of biologists who provide recommendations about deer management based on scientific data about the deer herd and the interaction between that deer herd and those people who have an interest in them. Here in the wildlife section, we often get questions from hunters and others who are interested in what the deer reduction zone corridors are, how they are determined, and why we even have them in the first place. Questions that we get are, is the goal to get rid of all the deer close to the roads? Or maybe eliminate the deer vehicle collisions completely? Or maybe some other purpose that no one is aware of? So let's take a few minutes and look at the purpose of these deer reduction zone corridors, how they are selected, and how they benefit both hunters and landowners in these communities. Deer reduction zones are used to target areas within Indiana that have high deer populations coupled with either a high density of people, such as urban areas, or a high use by people, such as heavily traveled roads. In any case, they are usually sited where the cultural carrying capacity has been exceeded. And this could have been exceeded possibly due to concerns over the local ecology, maybe deer vehicle collisions being high, or the amount of damage to personal property. Now, these areas are often underutilized by hunters because of access issues or the fact that hunters have not really thought about hunting in an urbanized area or an area that is highly used by people. Many hunters are looking to get back to the woods or maybe more natural areas, so hunting near a high-speed highway may not appeal to those hunters. Now, other hunters may be looking for new deer hunting challenges, but they may not know that hunting these abundant deer is even possible. When we designate an area as a deer reduction zone, the Division of Fish and Wildlife is looking to help manage the problems faced by these communities by providing hunters with additional opportunities to take deer within these areas. It's important to understand that the goal in these areas is to reduce deer-human conflict. It is not to eliminate the deer population or even completely eliminate conflict. That would be impossible. But by incorporating or increasing hunting in these areas, not only can the countywide deer population be better managed, but we hope that we can reduce collisions to a level that is more similar to areas with relatively low levels of deer vehicle collisions. The smallest deer management unit in Indiana has traditionally been at the county level, which is how we set our quotas for the bonus antlerless harvest. However, the use of the deer reduction zones allow the Indiana DNR to target areas within a county that have a higher allowable antlerless take without having to reduce the overall population of deer throughout a given county through these countywide antlerless harvest quotas. This should allow deer in one part of a county to remain stable or increase, while decreasing populations in another part of the same county. This also coincides with the current deer management plan in Indiana. The 5-year management plan is to strategically manage Indiana's deer herd. In some areas, that means there should be a larger deer population, while in others, the population should be maintained at the same levels or possibly even reduced. The deer reduction zones allow managers to strategically target such areas without having to reduce the countywide deer populations. The more traditional deer reduction zones that have been used in Indiana for years focused on areas around larger population centers, such as cities and towns, with a history of deer-related conflict. However, the Indiana DNR recognized that concentrated areas of conflict can occur around more rural areas, such as locations where high deer densities and high-speed traffic or large volume of traffic occur. Starting in 2018, the Indiana DNR is experimenting with deer reduction zones that target areas with high deer vehicle collisions in rural areas. These are centered on major highways, such as interstates and state roads, where the rates of deer vehicle collisions are significantly higher than other parts of the state. The objective of these zones is to reduce deer vehicle collisions along these stretches of highway without affecting the overall deer population in that county. Essentially, we are using a principle of wildlife management called compensatory mortality in an effort to try to reduce deer vehicle collisions and also provide additional opportunities for hunters. Compensatory mortality is when you replace one type of mortality with another type. This is the theoretical basis of sport hunting game species such as white-tailed deer. In general, moderate levels of sport hunting should not increase overall mortality when deer populations are relatively high levels. Natural mortality caused by factors such as exposure, starvation, disease, or predation is replaced with deer harvest by hunters. In this case, our objective is to harvest deer through hunting rather than having them being killed in deer vehicle collisions. And because the deer reduction corridors are limited to 1/2 mile on each side of the road, this should result in no functional change to the deer population in the area, just a change to the type of mortality that deer experience for deer whose home range overlaps with the highway. So rather than this valuable resource being wasted, hunters can harvest extra deer, which will result in a win for hunters interested in additional harvest opportunities and drivers on the highways in the form of less risk. This is an experimental type of deer reduction zone called a deer reduction zone corridor to distinguish it from that more traditional type of deer reduction zones that have been used in Indiana. This method of using a focused hunting area to address deer vehicle collisions was suggested by several Indiana deer hunters who recommended that the DNR try to focus hunter efforts in these areas where collisions occur to reduce this problem. Over the next few years, we will evaluate the effectiveness of these deer reduction zone corridors to see if hunter activity increases in these areas and if deer vehicle collisions are reduced. We will compare harvest rates and deer vehicle collisions with past data and with areas that are similar where there are no deer reduction zone corridors present. If it works, this would be a new and innovative method for addressing deer vehicle collisions and could be expanded to other areas if it proves to be effective in achieving the goals. The selection process for the deer reduction zone corridors is to map out the deer vehicle collisions in Indiana that are reported by various law enforcement personnel to the Indiana Department of Transportation. We then identify areas that have a statistically higher rate of collision than other parts of Indiana. A deer reduction zone corridor is drawn along a stretch of highway that encompasses these areas of high deer vehicle collisions, and that starts and stops at a recognizable boundary, such as a county line or another highway. The deer reduction zone corridor is 1/2 mile on each side from the center of the designated stretch of road. If any part of a private landowner's property parcel is included in that zone, the whole parcel can be hunted under the rules of a deer reduction zone corridor. If a landowner has multiple parcels, only the parcel that touches a deer reduction zone corridor can be hunted under the deer reduction zone rule. As with any deer reduction zone, it is up to the property owner to allow access or the additional harvest of bucks and does on their property. The deer reduction zone only provides the legal possibility of additional harvest. Once all those areas are identified, they are marked just like the other areas of conflict, and then they are discussed by the district biologist and the biologist in the deer program. Finally, each proposed deer reduction zone corridor is reviewed and evaluated to determine how the deer reduction zone corridor will affect hunting access and harvest in each area. The proposal is then reviewed by the administrators of the Division of Fish and Wildlife and ultimately the director of the Department of Natural Resources. If the proposal is accepted, a one-year temporary rule is written to allow the implementation of the deer reduction zone corridor. So how do these deer reduction zone corridors help reduce deer vehicle collisions? These new deer reduction zone corridors help address problems between deer and humans in these areas by providing hunters additional opportunity to remove deer that would have likely been hit by drivers. As mentioned before, the goal is to reduce the number of deer hit by vehicles in the immediate area of highways without causing a generalized reduction in the countywide deer population. This is in line with the current deer management plan of strategically managing the deer herd. So in some parts of a county, a reduction may be warranted. However, in other parts, it may not be necessary. The deer reduction zones are just a tool that allows the Division of Fish and Wildlife to target areas where the deer have exceeded the cultural carrying capacity of one stakeholder group, such as commuters and other drivers, while addressing the needs and cultural carrying capacity of another stakeholder group, Indiana's deer hunters. The research into the effectiveness of the program will help inform future decisions and can also be compared against the effectiveness of other methods to reduce deer vehicle collisions, such as the use of signs, fences, reduced traffic speeds, and other commonly used methods. It also makes hunters a partner in the management of conflict with deer, which is a common theme that we hear from hunters in discussions of managing conflict. In this case, we have identified the areas with the highest risk and put a tool into practice that will allow hunters additional opportunities to help address this societal problem. So that will wrap up our discussion on why we have these deer reduction zone corridors, what they are used for, and how they are selected. For specific information on all the current deer reduction zones, as well as more information on how Indiana DNR manages your deer herd, please visit the Indiana DNR Deer Hunting, Biology, and Management website at deer.dnr.in.gov.